What's up, everybody? We made it to our Airbnb. I should put down this stupid lens cap. We made it to our Airbnb in Florence. We're very excited to go out, so let you know how it goes. Good morning. I'm a little hungover from yesterday's events.
Baby, you look and sound like right now, so maybe let's start over from the top. This is you. Good morning, I'm hungover today.
I'm giving the people the realness.
Yeah, and then you're gonna get Dusty and other people texting you like, man, you okay? You really look like shit in that video.
Okay,
you look
all right.
Hungover.
So after last night, we celebrated our 1 year anniversary. Very exciting stuff.
Of being married.
Very exciting. Today we're gonna go to a cooking class and hang out with Anna's cousin Olivia.
Olivia is studying in Naples right now, so she took a bus and has met us up here in Florence. So we're gonna go take a cooking class with a pretty sick ass view.
We walked around and explored a bit before heading to our cooking class, and I thought the streets were packed. Apparently, this is the slow tourist season, and this isn't crowded at all.
When we got to our cooking class location, we were shocked to see the view was exactly as advertised. Olivia and Nick were on tiramisu duty, but Nick messed up his portion a little bit.
How long have you been mixing?
Like 20 minutes.
And why is that?
Because I broke an egg and the egg yolk got in here.
So Nick's trying to make whipped cream, but he got the egg yolk in with the egg whites and adding a bunch more time to it.
From there, we dipped our lady fingers into our liquid and arranged them to make our tiramisu. And then we put them in the fridge to enjoy later.
After this, we poured out our ingredients to make our pasta dough. All we needed was flour and an egg. After working our dough out a little bit and rolling it, we were able to cut the pasta into strips.
We really enjoyed the food that we made, but the wine, views, and people we were with really made this one special.
So yesterday, after my cousin Olivia left, after we had our cooking class, today we decided to take another cooking class with a woman who I've actually cooked before within Florence. Her name is Illiana. And we're here at the market shopping with her, and you'll get to follow us along with how we cook some delicious food with her. Let's go. Illiana took us to the market, Mercado de Sant'ambrogio, which had a ton to choose from for our meal. There was everything you could need to make a delicious meal. Fresh fruits, vegetables, herbs, seasonings, meat, cheese. I was honestly really impressed with this place. We
We were making everything from scratch in this class, so it's really important to get the freshest ingredients. Of course, while we looked around, we got a little hungry and we needed to buy a snack.
I think I want to get some wild strawberries, and then we'll also get like some fresh strawberries, because like this normally isn't in season, and I didn't see it back in Poland, so I kind of like want to get it.
This market was way less touristic from the central market, and one of the best places to buy fruit and vegetables in Florence. I would highly recommend it.
So these are technically called wild strawberry, but they're called pajanki in Polish, and like they're like much tinier than like the average strawberry. That's what we're dealing with, right? They also just like, they smell like sweeter and tartar, and like you can't get this in America. Like this doesn't exist. So yeah, like melts in your mouth.
Oh yeah.
Taste the difference?
Yeah, it's really good.
It's good, right?
Yeah, these are really good.
No, Rick, I told you, dude, fruit's better in Europe.
Oh yeah.
We headed from the market over to Illiana's place to start cooking. Of course, what's cooking without a spritz, some meat, and cheese to tide us over? Illiana was a great host for us, and we really loved her hospitality.
We started by making gnocchi from scratch. I find this part extremely satisfying to watch. Here's what the gnocchi looked like before we cooked them. After we were done with our gnocchi, we moved into the kitchen to start on our sauces. Illiana was fantastic at explaining the process and why we were doing what we were doing. This artichoke was for the pasta sauce later. We moved back into the main room to start rolling out our pasta. This time we were using a press rather than rolling it out by hand, so our final result of pasta was a lot more uniform and normal looking. Once the pasta was cut, we were able to hang them on a little tiny rack so that they could dry and not stick together.
Gnocchi going into the pot. And mixing with our sauce.
You said it, Illiana. These were our final products when we were done, and they were absolutely delicious. I couldn't believe that we actually made them. That's it for us this week. Hit that subscribe button if you want to watch more of our Italy adventure. Bye!